For AR or VR, this is gonna be an insane scanner for the price. All right, guys. It's finally here. We've got the Einstar Vega. Now this is the all-in-one handheld scanner from Shining3D, and it's got a screen on it, so it's completely standalone. Finally, they've gone into the realm of wireless 3D scanning. So we've got it here. We're gonna unbox it, show you everything you get when you order it from visionminer.com. We've got these in stock and ready to ship, and we've also got some examples and stuff later in the video to show you how it performs. Now, totally transparent up front, as always, this is a hobbyist scanner. Don't expect super professional sub-millimeter accuracy for reverse engineering or for inspection. Do expect a much better experience than a lot of the competition out there on the market. They have always done really, really good in the user experience department and just the solid hardware. These machines rarely need repairs or fixing or even troubleshooting. They're just solid machines. So, let's get right into it. Let me open up this box and we'll show you everything you get inside. So you'll notice it does have a battery sticker on it now, which the other scanners did not, and that is indicative of a portable handheld unit. Now, upon release of the Vega, they did offer four or five different colors. They had blue, they had gold. This is the silver blue edition. Those colors were only for pre-order. So if you're seeing this video, they might be available still. Give us a call and we'll check stock directly with Shiny to see if we can still get you any of the colors. But moving forward, it will simply be the magnesium box. It's colored in titanium. It's actually a magnesium enclosure. And that standard one is a little bit lighter than the aluminum colored version. So personally, I'd go with the standard version myself anyway, and I love titanium, so it's a good time. Let's see here, what do we got? We've got the box, and we've got a carrying case in the box, not bad. Now we've got what looks like a board. So this actually holds the calibration board in place for when you're doing calibration. Set that over here. And you have a pretty funky looking wrist strap here. These are much better than the other wrist straps you get with a lot of other equipment. This thing is burly, definitely. Definitely a good wrist strap. FreeScan Combo comes with the same one in black, actually. And it looks like a USB charging block. And it is a 65 watt dual USB-C charging block. Very nice. There's the specs for anybody that wants it. All right, good times. Finally moving into the modern era with the battery charging these days. Just give you a nice USB-C block. Let's check out inside the box itself. All right, so what have we here? Got the unit itself. This looks like the USB-C charging cable. So it's USB-C to USB-C. Very good. A cool looking little tripod here. This is pretty sweet. It is branded Einstar. So let's check this out. So these knobs, it actually looks like this will go to a much more severe angle. Much better than the old Pro HD tripods they used to supply back in the day. They've upgraded massively. That's great to see. All right, so. Looks like we've got some scanner markers. All right, this is probably about 1,000 or so scanner markers. 6 millimeter, it appears. So you can use those for any scanning projects, for large objects, or anything that needs markers because it doesn't have enough geometry. This thing will probably track in geometry or marker mode, so you can place markers on a large flat surface and scan that, or if it has a lot of unique geometry, should be able to scan that without much trouble at all. And in the back here, we have a calibration board. Oh yeah. All right, here you go. Very cool, calibration board, and then another little calibration board on the back. So the big one, I would imagine, is for the fast mode, and then the smaller ones are gonna be, these are tiny little markers, those are like 2 millimeters, 3 millimeters maybe. That's likely for a more high resolution mode. Or high detail. All right, we'll keep that nice and clean inside there. And is that it? Looks like we got a carrying strap for the case itself. So if you're lugging this thing around town, looks like, yep, it'll attach right on these little edges here. So you can just have that. You can have a little sling bag for your scanner. All right, so the unit itself, let's check this out right here. Beautiful screen. You got a little bit of a bezel around it. Looks like it comes in this silicone case. Something they started doing with the Einstar, actually. So beautiful. Look at all these cameras on the back here. Gorgeous. And the screen itself. I feel like these are projectors back here, and then you got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cameras, maybe. And some other lights and sensors. That's a deep pocket thing. Look at that. All right. Oh, let's check out the tripod functionality real quick. Okay, they really stepped their game up on tripod because this thing is easy. It went on like a breeze. I can adjust it, bring it down lower if I want to. Oh, that's actually really nice. Sweet, so let's take it out of the silicone sleeve and see what we got there. Ooh. All right, so this is the silver blue model. If you look right into that little vent there, you can see the copper heat sinks inside. Yeah, you can kind of see it there. That's pretty sweet. It's like a really big smartphone. Hello. By the way, if you don't already, check out our Instagram and our Facebook and our LinkedIn. We are on every social media platform, and we're putting out content on a regular basis. So if you don't already, follow us there. And if you don't here, definitely subscribe if you want to see more content like this. We basically get high-end professional technology and additive manufacturing and 3D scanning, and we demystify it for you. And we sell it at visionminer.com. So if you want to support what we're doing here, you want more content like this, definitely check this out. Let's put her back in the silicone boot and turn her on real quick. I'm gonna hold this button down just for a couple seconds. Ah. Okay, so it's immediately in scanning mode, in HD and fast mode, and then we've got your frames per second. You've got some settings over here, object or portrait mode. Very cool. Acquire texture, so that'll get your color texture if you're scanning stuff and want the full color. For AR or VR, this is gonna be an insane scanner for the price. It probably won't hold a light to the H2, but for AR, VR stuff, this is gonna be a really cool utility. Alignment modes, texture or marker or both, very cool. Portrait mode, obviously no marker alignment there. You're not putting markers on somebody's face. And you can acquire texture. All right, cool. And then let's click this. It looks like this is giving me the exposure, or is this an actual bright? Oh, this is a brightness adjustment. Oh, that's super cool. That's dope. All right, so if I pull the brightness up, yeah, it's just, oh, that's sweet. Okay, and then you click this, data quality indicator, texture display. Oh, you can choose one or the other, or neither. All right, looks like we can't display the texture right now, but let's give this a shot. There's a play button right here. Let's see what happens. All right. It's tracking okay. I am pretty close. Nice, all right, good times. Cool, all right, well, that's enough playing around for right now. What we're gonna do is actually gonna go use this thing for a little bit, and I'm gonna get some of the opinions of the team to see what they actually think using this thing around the office. See what kind of results we get, how well it works, does it track, does it get good resolution scans? So I'm basically expecting this thing to perform as well as an Einstar, except it's self-contained. It's got a battery and a screen, so you could just throw this literally in your backpack, go somewhere and scan stuff with it. Again, probably not on the professional level for inspection, metrology, but for some basic reverse engineering or AR, VR, getting real life objects and putting them into a video game or a virtual environment or something, this unit is gonna be very cool for that. So with that, let's go into what the guys think. So guys, I just wanna bring in some of the team to get their first impressions. They've been running around with the unit and experiencing it compared to the FreeScan and the HX and all the other professional scanners. So far, what do you think?
Well, after using this scanner for about, let's say, a good 30 minutes to an hour, I'm gonna say it actually met my expectations. I figured it was gonna be an Einstar in a handheld, and not only is it an Einstar in a handheld, it actually does better than the Einstar. The tracking is better, the color is improved, and I just like the feel of it. I mean, I'm a video game guy, and this, as soon as I got it on my hands, it felt just like a Nintendo DS or a Switch, things like that. For the price point, for what my expectations were, it met them.
Nice. All right. Well, what are your impressions for like overall usability and the user interface? Is it easy to find stuff? Easy to, you know, select features and
whatnot? Pretty easy. But with any new fancy gadget, you're gonna have to navigate through the software, the options, find where everything's at. After that, it was cake. It was just like using the Einstar, but in handheld mode. What I really like, though, what really stood out to me as you're waiting for the data to process is they have a lot of neat little tips for you to go off of. I don't want to be biased and just throw out pure positives. The only thing I would say that we can work on with the Einstar Vega is the battery life. Hour, 2 hours tops before you throw that charger in there, you gotta charge it all over to keep going.
That being said, you can plug a power bank into it.
You can plug a power bank into it.
Scan.
Scan away, they'll give you much more time. In all honesty, if you're gonna be scanning hour, 2 hours, 3-4 hours, you're probably gonna wanna go with a more experienced type of scanner like the HX or the Free Scan Combo. To me, this is kind of like the scanner that I'll keep in my backpack. If I see a cool statue, if I meet my favorite celebrity, I'm gonna pop this bad boy out and start scanning. Boom, 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 let me see what you got. Throw them back in my pocket and let's go. I liked it. Einstar who? Vega's in town now.
Yes, awesome. Thank you, Lonzo.
Thank you.
Appreciate the input. So here we've got Jay. Jay, you've also had a little bit of hands-on time with the Vega. What are your thoughts? You've used all the different scanners to a certain extent.
I like it. It's small. It's kind of like an Einstar, but in an all-in-one inclusive kind of thing. It's the screen's on there. Everything's on there. It's great. I love it. It's got the texture scan, which is capture the color, and then it's got the fast mode and HD mode. Now, I know the fast mode is for like people, go out farther, got a wider field of view, and for the HD mode, you got to get closer. One thing about this scanner, though, it's a little bit slow when it's rendering. So the speed of it, you can, because it's got all the computer inside of it.
How long does it take to, like, you scan something and then you hit process? How long are you waiting?
Roughly about 10 minutes. So, I mean, it's not that long, right?
But cool, yeah. Not bad. What do you think about the interface and everything?
User-friendly. You know, if you use an iPhone or Android, I mean, this touchscreen is pretty easy to use.
It is a really nice touch. It could be an LED. It's a nice screen, that's for sure. Any other thoughts compared to, like, using the HX or something like that? Is it?
I mean, the HX and the Free Scan, right? We're using those for, like, the laser mode, you know, scanning the hood, things like that, dark object. Well, the battery, we were at 100%, and we were using about for about half an hour, 45 minutes, and we were down to about 65%.
Maybe 2 hours out of scanning.
Roughly about that in the real world, I think, yeah. I mean, carry around like a power bank would help for sure.
Standard USB-C power bank, you can get them on Amazon for $30, and that'll add a lot of time to your scanning abilities. Thank you, Jay.
You got it, man.
Awesome. All right, guys, so that is the unboxing and first look of the Einstar Vega. If you want to buy this unit, go straight to visionminer.com/scanners. And while you're there, if you're doing this for professional applications, check out the other range of scanners we have. And if you're curious about what you'd really get between this and the other units that are available, then just give us a call or shoot us an email. We are here to help and consult you and your business to see which one's actually going to be the best for what you're doing. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment down below. What do you want us to scan on the next video to give you the best idea of what this thing's capabilities really are? We're gonna put it through its paces, and we wanna hear from you what you wanna see. Other than that, have a positive rest of your day. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.